Hey Greenfield artists, if you are paying attention to that intro, you've probably already guessed that the next theme we're going to explore is food.
Food.
So let's get down to it. The meat and the potatoes of the matter, if you will. Food is so essential. Or in other words, important for our everyday lives. We all need it. We all need to eat food to survive. So it's no wonder it's become a popular subject for artists to make art about. Looking back, food has always played a role in art. Stone Age cave painters used vegetable juice and animal fat mixed together to make paint. And they used this paint to draw and tell stories on cave walls. And the Egyptians carved pictographs of crops and even bread into their hieroglyphic tablets. During the Renaissance, an Italian artist named Giuseppe Arcimboto painted whimsical puzzle-like portraits in which our facial features were represented by different fruits and vegetables. He even composed some portraits of fish. And during the pop art era of the 1960s, artist Wing Thiebaud used familiar food items you would get at a diner or a grocery store to make a statement about commodification. Wait, what's commodification?
Commodification is taking something people once thought of as rare and special and turning it into something common or easy to buy.
In the 1970s, an artist named Judy Chicago took the idea of food one step further. She designed an entire room made of a huge triangular table set with place settings, that's plates, knives, forks, spoons, and napkins, each designed for an important woman from history that she would like to invite to dinner. Think Cleopatra, Madame Curie, all important women sitting at one table. Can you imagine the conversations that they would share over this dinner? And lastly, I need you to hold on to your hat because you're not even going to believe this. One artist named Dieter Roth actually had the idea to fill 37 suitcases with cheese. He called it Cheese, a Race, and he hung the suitcases at the top of a gallery ceiling. And as the cheese melted and rotted over the summer, it oozed down the side of the gallery walls. Can you imagine what that art exhibit smelled like? I bet all the critics said, "This art stinks." The truth is, a lot of artists use food itself to make art out of. Take the artist Vic Muniz. He actually created an artwork called Double Mona Lisa, Peanut Butter and Jelly, where he recreated the famous portrait by Leonardo da Vinci in, you guessed it, peanut butter and jelly. Whew, that was a lot of art history there. Thanks for listening. But now it's your turn to create a kind of art inspired by food. Start by watching the video that I've linked for you from California artist Sean Charmont. It is hysterical. I think you'll really enjoy it. And one of the project options you'll have is based on his work. After you've checked out Sean's video, your job is to check out the menu of your project options. You can either decide to set up a still life using food found in your kitchen. This is probably the most traditional option. You can focus on one object or make a grouping, but try your best and try to include as many details as possible. Your second choice will be an animation option. You can use the free app called iMotion HD. We have that on the iPads at school, and it's a really fun and easy app you can use to create a short stop animation film. If that all sounds a little bit complicated, you can click on this link for a video that I've created myself on how to work with iMotion HD. Your third choice is a sculpture project. You can follow these simple directions to make a kind of clay at home called salt dough. It's really simple. Just make sure you ask for permission from your family first. It just takes flour, salt, and a little bit of water, and you can create your own realistic food creation. The fourth option uses Sean Sharman's art as an inspirational kind of jumping off point. You'll use Google Drawing to create an original personified food scene of your own. This is one of Sean's pieces here, a hilarious pear ripping the sticker, ouch, off of an apple. If you need help learning how to create a artwork like this, you can click on the link and I will be there with a lesson for how to. And the final option I've created for you is a little bit of art criticism for my critics out there. I want you to look up these two artworks, the one I mentioned before by Vic Muniz, the peanut butter Mona Lisa, and I want you to compare and contrast these two works of art by answering these three questions below. Remember, artists, you only need to choose one of those options. Some of you have been turning in two or three responses. Don't think I don't appreciate that. But for those of you who may be feeling stressed, I'm going to give you 2 weeks to turn this in, and I also want to make sure you know you only need to choose one of the choices. Your artwork is due by Friday, May 8th, and you're doing a good job of turning things in on the Google Classroom. You can submit your artwork as a picture or a doc or even a PDF. Or a Google Drawing. Whatever you decide, they are all compatible with Google Classrooms, and I look forward to see what you create. Until next time, I'm gonna go make a salad or something. Peace.